It's Friday 12th of January. Happy New Year! Welcome to the first edition of Wycombe High TV News of 2024 from the UK's only student-led TV channel. I'm Ira in Year 7.
And I'm Jasmine, and I'm also a student in Year 7. And here are this week's Wycombe High headlines.
Reasons why Wycombe High: how these videos made by students have seen hundreds apply to join our sixth form.
Highly talented, the two Year 8 students who've been starring in the London's West End.
Plus, in our first show of 2024, students reveal their New Year's resolutions.
My New Year's resolution is to be more organised with school and homework and have a better sleep schedule.
But first, it's been a big week for all our 192 Year 8 students this week with the GCSE Options Fair to help them decide which subjects they want to study for their GCSEs. Our reporter, Amani, in Year 11, went along to this exciting event to find out more.
Hi, I'm Amani and I'm here today at the Year 8 Options Fair. Let's take a look inside. I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on.
All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet.
I found the fair like really enjoyable, and I got a really good opportunity to talk to a lot of the older students who have already been through the exams as well. Can you tell me what sort of things I need to revise for and like what's in the exams?
It was really helpful, and I got to know a lot more about the subjects that I was interested in choosing, so yeah.
It's been really good, and we get to talk to lots of the younger students about how good drama is.
It's really interactive and I learned a lot, and the sweets are also really good.
It's been really interesting, and we thought that the drama subject was really persuasive, and now we're like,
definitely choose drama.
Yeah.
It's fabulous. It's really helped me decide on my way to what I'm going to pick for GCSE, and there are so many great options. So just dance, dance, dance. Ooh, it's something magical. It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. I don't need no reason, don't be control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine.
I really like the fair, and especially I enjoyed art because I learned a lot about it, and I think I might choose it.
I really like the fair, and it's made me want to choose geography more, and I really like it.
Well, it's really good. There's a lot for each subject. I think I know what I want to do now, so yay!
It's really interesting. I now know what I'm going to choose for GCSE.
Oh, you can see there's such a real buzz in the hall all around us. It's so important for the Year 8s. It's a chance for them to really tease out some of the differences between the different GCSEs that are on offer for them.
Yep, and it's a really good opportunity for the Year 8s to be able to talk to the current students who are really studying the subjects, as well as their teachers, to have a real chance to think about their next step. So, really exciting afternoon here.
And if you're still making up your mind which GCSEs to choose, there's loads of information in the Year 8 Options section of our website, including a brand new subject-by-subject digital guide, as well as short videos covering all 15 subjects on offer. Here's a little taste.
I'm in one of our computing labs with our subject lead for computer science, Mr. Quinnell. So why should our students choose computer science GCSE?
Computer science is all about problem solving. It's about creative thinking. And if you've got a passion for computing, you should do it.
And where can it lead you?
Lots of different areas. You don't have to just focus on programming or the computer industry. every type of industry will use technology, and understanding that is going to be really important, especially in the future.
Hi, Olivia. Why did you choose computer science GCSE?
I chose computer science because I wasn't given opportunities like this in my primary school, and I was excited to learn new skills that would be helpful to me in the future.
And what sort of skills have you focused in on so far?
Well, we've been learning about what's inside the CPU and how the computer works, and we've also been doing lots of coding on Python.
And do you think that you'll end up carrying those skills forward to life beyond the GCSE?
Definitely, definitely.
Well, good luck with the rest of it. Thank you very much. And I've also got Zara here. Zara, why did you choose the computer science option?
I was very interested in how the inside of computer worked and how the different functions connected to things like the CPU and the memory.
Fantastic. It does sound really interesting. And have you been enjoying the course so far?
Yes, and I think I might take it up further as well in A-level and maybe as my profession.
Hi, Akshita. Can you tell us, why did you choose computer science GCSE?
I chose computer science GCSE because the world is becoming more and more digital because, well, look at the impact AI has had over just a year. I always wanted to learn what was inside a computer and coding and how to run it, and I just think I would have lots more job opportunities.
Fantastic. And have you been enjoying the course so far?
I really have. We have a balance between theory and practical, and it's just a really nice subject.
Such an exciting time for Year 8, looking forward to our turn next year. And that's not the only video series creating a buzz here at Wycombe High. Our reasons why Wycombe High filmed for students thinking of studying their A-levels here at the best secondary school in Britain have already had thousands of social media views and prompted hundreds of applications. The videos cover all our aspects of our amazing sixth form experience. Today's video, for example, is all about how Wycombe High is a class leader in helping to expand your knowledge.
Sixth form at Wycombe High School challenges you to prepare for a successful future with A-level lessons focusing on stretching your understanding and broadening your perspective.
Teachers teach topics that they're really passionate about, and this encourages really interesting debate in the classroom and encourages you to read broadly around your subject.
We also have an incredible library with over 11,000 books, which really helps with wider reading in subjects and also just for enjoyment. We have a lot of EPQ research as well, and we're open till 6 in the evening.
Well, as you saw there in the video, if you want to join our sixth form, you've got just 7 days left to apply. The deadline is next Friday. All the details you need are in the sixth form section of our website. Now, as well as welcoming in the new year, Wycombe High has also been welcoming Mrs. Castleton, our new subject lead in the English department. Our reporter, Zairu, in year 7, went along to say hello.
So, welcome to Wycombe High. Could you start off telling us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, I have been teaching for around about 20 years now. I obviously, as an English teacher, I really love books and reading. I enjoy travelling as well. I actually lived in Sri Lanka for a couple of years and taught out there for a couple of years, which was an amazing experience. And I enjoy lots of sports, in particular running. Last year I ran my first ever ultra marathon, which is not something that I want to repeat in a hurry, but I'm glad I did it. So yeah, just I like to be active and keep busy.
And why did you want to become an English teacher?
Obviously, I love the subject. I love reading, I love books, I love discussing those things. But I had some really inspirational teachers when I was at school that really inspired me not only to study English at university, but also to want to teach. And yeah, I've loved teaching since.
So obviously now you're head of English. What are your plans for the English department? Okay.
So nothing too major at the moment. Obviously I'm trying to find my feet in terms of the department. Something that I'm really interested in is some bringing in some opportunities for some trips and theatre visits, and getting out and seeing sort of literature and theatre in the real world.
Thank you. And finally, what is your favourite book and why?
There's too many. If I had to pick one, it would be Test of the D'Urbervilles by Thomas Hardy. I studied it when I was at school, and so it is one of the first books that really captured my imagination. But Tess as a character, there's a tragedy to her, but there's also a strength and a determination to her that makes her such a great character.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes, a big Wycombe High welcome to Miss Castleton, and thank for talking to Wycombe High TV. Now, as regular viewers will know, there is never a week that goes by without at least one of our students doing something remarkable. This week we're celebrating Annie and Sophie in Year 8, who have been starring in a production on the West End stage.
Hi, I'm Amani and I'm here today with Annie and Sophia, who've performed in a West End theatre production. So Annie, for the viewers at home who don't know, could you please tell us a little bit about what the production was like?
Well, Sophia and I were performing in a show called Across the Line, and we were performing with an academy called PQA, and there were two other academies that were with us, and it was a really fun and cool experience to see what it'd be like to perform in front of a crowd and like sing and dance, and it was really cool.
That sounds so fun. And what was the audition process like?
Well, you had to sing a few songs that were fun and jovial, and then for the acting side of it, we had to use some script work just to see how the characters were presented.
And I'm sure the rehearsals must have been quite long.
Yeah, I think it was from 9 months, from February all the way to October.
Wow, that sounds like a really long time. And Annie, has that inspired you to perhaps pursue an acting career?
Yeah, I think so. It was really, really cool to, because all the people were so fun to work with, and it was really cool to
Right? And what about you, Sophia?
Yeah, but I don't think I want to get on the stage. I'd prefer to be either backstage or do some lighting or sound, which I think is very interesting.
Yeah, that sounds really cool. And thank you so much, guys.
Thank you.
Well done, Annie and Sophie. Congratulations, too, to our under 13 netball team who have qualified for the quarterfinals of the School Sports Magazine National Schools Cup. That puts them in the top 8 schools in the UK. What an achievement.
Meanwhile, our under 15 netball team are through to the 4th round of the National School Cup and play next week to try and progress into the quarterfinals too. Also next week, our under 13s and under 15s football teams will be playing in the county quarterfinals.
Good luck to all 4 teams. Go Wick High! Don't forget, you can catch up with all things Wycombe High 7 days a week via the school socials and our website, wycombehighschool.com.
And we'll leave you for this week, with students revealing their New Year's resolutions. Wonder if they'll keep them. Goodbye.
Have a great weekend. Goodbye.
Hi, my name's Karina and I'm in Year 7.
Hi, my name's Eva and I'm also in Year 7.
And today we're going to be asking Wycombe High students what their New Year's resolutions are.
What's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution is to learn a new skill.
My New Year's resolution is to work harder in school and achieve better grades in class.
My New Year's resolution is to find out more about my religion.
My New Year's resolution is to make more, even more friends than I already have.
My New Year's resolution is to try a new sport or maybe extracurricular activity.
So what's your New Year's resolution?
To not be late to school.
My New Year's resolution is to try wear a hijab more often.
My New Year's resolution would be to try journalize more.
My New Year's resolution is to be more organized with school and homework and have a better sleep schedule.
My New Year's resolution would be to clear out any useless things in the house because I feel like I have so much that I never use that I need to throw out.
My New Year's resolution is to make more friends and be more social.
My New Year's resolution is to spend more time with my pets.
So what's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution is to see my friends more and go out with them.
So those are Wycombe High students' New Year resolutions.
Bye!
Happy New Year!